Hi everyone, and thanks for stopping by my channel. I'm Sarah from theaveragetourist.com, and today I'm going to be sharing with you my top 5 tips for visiting Disneyland as an adult. Tip number 1, choose your dates wisely. Disneyland has 3 kinds of tickets you can choose from: peak, regular, and value. We chose the value tickets because it saved us some money and because we thought it would be less busy on those days. We went on a Tuesday and a Wednesday, and the crowds were still pretty big. So tip number 1 is choose your dates wisely. Tip number 2 is to pay attention to ticket prices. I purchased my tickets directly from the Disneyland website and noticed that there was kind of a price discrepancy between individual tickets and park hopper passes. So I purchased 4 individual value tickets instead of 2 2-day park hopper passes. We could only go to 1 park each day, but we wanted to spend a whole day at each park anyway, so it worked out for us and we saved some money. So tip number 2, pay attention to ticket prices. Tip number 3, Disneyland has an app. We didn't know that they had an app, and we also didn't have a US data plan for while we were there, but it would have been really handy to have this app. It had GPS, a map of the park, and it told you where characters are and the wait times for most of the rides, which would have been extremely handy. We used the paper map, which worked just as well. However, it didn't have all of those additional features that the app did. So tip number 3, look into the Disneyland app. Tip number 4, you can bring your own food and drinks into the park. We didn't know this on our first day, so on our second day when we went back, we brought some water and some snacks, and it saved us a bit of money, so we didn't have to purchase everything while we were there. As you know, the food is pretty overpriced, and you have to wait in some pretty long lines to even get food. So save yourself the hassle, save yourself some money, and tip number 4 is bring your own food and drinks. Tip number 5, bring proper ID. My husband and I are from Canada, and we brought our driver's licenses with us. However, we found out at Disney California Adventure Park that if you want to have an alcoholic drink, you actually have to bring a passport with you if you're outside of the US. So make sure you have proper ID with you if you want to have a drink. I'm not sure that it's worth it bringing your passport just in case it gets lost or stolen and you need to get home, but something to note, if you do want to have a drink at Disney California Adventure Park, you need your passport. So there you have it, my top 5 tips for visiting Disneyland as an adult. I've actually written a blog post about it and I linked it in the description below. There I've included a few additional tips for anyone who's planning a trip to Disney that may be helpful. So if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel. I'll be posting additional travel videos very soon, and I hope to have you back.